Okay. Lucas, my name is Khurshid. I'm from Uncle K Live TV and
Radio.
Nice
to meet you, Khurshid. Hi.
Thank
Pleasure.
You.
Pleasure.
Thank
Welcome
you.
To Unilever Food Solutions.
And thank you. And your name, does this have any Viking and Dutch background?
Oh, no. I'm actually coming from Austria, from Vienna.
Okay. All right.
No Dutch background.
So it has that German
Yes,
sounding.
Yes.
Okay.
German
because
influence.
The Lever and Unilever, it is actually a Dutch company,
it's
right?
It's a Dutch-British company, yes.
Dutch-British
yes.
company. Okay, now you have made it clear for me. So could you tell our viewers who are mainly newcomers investing in Dubai what it takes to start a company and how did you people establish here?
Okay.
Maybe you were the only company importing these things at that time because I'm here from 66 and it was British rule.
Yep.
So you people had the advantage or maybe you still had at that time also competition.
Mm. So basically when you look at Unilever Food Solutions, we are the food service division within Unilever.
Okay.
Unilever is a really big FMCG company globally. And what we do is actually we share the same brands like our mother company Unilever. So we have Lipton, Knorr and Hellmann's. But we are focusing on food service, so that means we are catering to chefs in hotels and restaurants. If you look at our products, they are specifically made for professionals, so you will not find them in supermarkets. We distribute them directly through our distribution partners to hotels and restaurants, to chefs. Now, when you look at the portfolio, actually, what we did when we set up the business here, we were trying to bring in the best products across the globe, actually. We are present in 74 countries at the moment. What makes us unique, we have actually 300 chefs working for us globally. Here in this region, and when I talk about this region, it's Middle East, Pakistan, and Sri Lanka, we have 7 chefs. And what they do is actually they develop products and develop new recipes. Now, I mentioned that when we started here, we brought in products from across the globe. What we now developed specifically for this market is something which is called, for example, shishtok marinade. Or we just launched another product, which is shawarma, beef shawarma marinade. And all we do is actually we want to, you know, make it easier for the chef. This example, marination time with our marinades cut in half. So, for example, when you talk about shishtok, normally it takes 4 to 6 hours to marinate. Our product does it in 2. So we really try to bring new products into the market which are relevant for chefs, which help them, you know, ease their kitchen process and kitchen operation.
Without losing the quality or the taste?
Without losing the quality, without losing the taste. Because chefs, they don't like to change the taste. So what we do is actually we enhance the taste sometimes, but we guarantee him he can use it, our product as a base, for example.
I was
but
coming
give
to
him,
it's a new
give him,
thing they can add
give
on
him the freedom to play with it, you know,
very
because
good.
Chefs are very creative people. They don't want to have ready-to-use products in most of the
very
cases. They want to play with it.
Okay. Now, Lucas, I know you won't be able to know what I'm going to ask because this is a long history of the company. They started just as distributors, but they started manufacturing also. For example, Lipton was not there, so they were just distributing it. Then they took over the company. Same way with Brookbond, same way with Igloo, Walls. I mean, whatever they are distributing, they later on own that company. So how do they work that philosophy? I don't know. Because you are not expert in each and everything. How do they do it?
Well, but it's not only taking over, but we also, you know, when we acquire a company like Lipton, for example, and that was years back, it's also, you know, also the people that come with that company. So they have the knowledge. So it's not only that we buy companies and we don't, you know, take over the people. So it's
you
all
don't
about
change the management. Okay.
Not necessarily.
Okay.
So that means yes, the brands are quite old. We are working with, but also we have the knowledge in the company. So we are number one manufacturers in tea actually globally. So, but we also have the right knowledge. We have tea tasters. They go all across the world looking for the different, you know, tea blends, making sure that Lipton tea also tastes, which fits to the local countries actually.
Exactly. You have a lot of variety in Lipton.
Specifically, you know, when you talk about food and beverages, it's all about taste in the end, yeah?
Taste and habit forming. I mean, you people have coached us into that particular brand. Yeah, if you don't see that tag on that tea bag, it's Lipton. It could be any tea, but if there's a Lipton bag, you say, okay, this is what I want.
Yeah, but brand is only one thing, but we need to deliver or keep delivering the promises we do in terms of quality.
Which come with the brand.
Yeah, which come with the brand.
Expectations.
Yes. Correct. But also, if you don't look at only the brands like Lipton or Knorr, but we're doing much more actually. Unilever has launched a Unilever Sustainability Living Plan. Unilever Sustainable Living Plan, USLP.
Okay.
So that means we work together with thousands of farmers and make sure they get the right wages. There is an 11-step program actually where we make sure Unilever lives up to his promise and does its part in terms of CRM and sustainability actually.
And giving them the right profit, I mean, not becoming a monopoly and just playing with the price of the product.
But for example, let's take one of our products where we have tomatoes inside.
Okay.
What we say is, for example, all our tomatoes are being sun-ripe, so they are not coming out of the greenhouse. So we make sure that a lot of our, you know, farmers, they do organic growing, for example. We make sure they get the right wages being paid. We make sure that they are not that they are changing the crop year after year.
Okay. So it's follow not your, I mean, your criteria, whatever
yes,
you
correct.
Get. Now, one thing, just last question. You say Unilever, and what is the name the company is using here in Dubai?
It's called Unilever.
Yeah, so you said that's your head office.
No, so what I'm saying is, so there is Unilever, and we are Unilever Food Solutions.
Okay,
so we are the division,
B2B
food service within Unilever.
Okay, but it is Unilever, our division, the separate division.
Yes,
of
correct,
food.
Yes.
Okay, all right. Thank you very much, Lucas.
It's a pleasure.
Have been very kind, giving
Thank
us the
you very
time.
Much.
I know you are busy.